Hello there, I'm Norman J. Warren, here at FrightFest 2016. Well, I'm here actually to support David McGilvray on his worst fears release and the horror icon mockumentary, I think it is actually, about him. So that was my main reason for coming. But to be honest, I've been coming to FrightFest every year, actually, ever since its beginning, starting at the Prince Charles Theatre. Because I've always enjoyed it. And I've liked supporting the four guys that started it and continued. I just think it's amazing just how it's grown. And it's so popular now. So it's just lovely to be here and to see how successful it is. And I would recommend it to any young filmmaker, certainly, to come to FrightFest. I think it's an important thing. Well, I think the main thing is what attracted me to horror is the fact when you're doing with horror, you're not dealing with reality 100%. In other words, you have freedom of imagination when you're making a horror film. As a director, you have so much freedom, whereas if you were working with straight drama, you actually are confined by reality. Whereas in a horror film, you can always say, well, it's not the real world, you know, it's supernatural or whatever, so you can go into a complete fantasy world and no one questions it. And I think that, from the audience's point of view, is exactly the same, because it does take them into a world that they wouldn't normally experience. You know? Science fiction is also another good example, probably even more so, because science fiction is completely made up. You know, so those are my main reasons. There is one, but it wasn't really a complete out-and-out horror film. And I'm going back a very long time now, because I was a little boy, a very young boy, when I saw it. My father took me to see a film called The Beast with Five Fingers, with Peter Lorre. And it was a story about a severed hand that tries to take revenge. And there was a wonderful scene where Peter Lorre has to nail the hand to a piece of wood to try and keep it under control. But the hand pulls itself off and then go back on a rampage again, strangling people. Well, that scene stayed in my mind forever, you know, and I wanted to see more. So as soon as I got old enough to be able to go and see the horror films of the day, that was it. So I would say that was the film that probably put the horror feeling into me, or the thing of saying, I wanted to do this, you know, get involved with this. So. Horror, I know lots of people are not going to agree when I say this, but it's still a relatively easy film to get to make, the type of film, simply because you don't necessarily need big name actors in it. So that is a big saving, and you can, and particularly now with digital, you can actually make your film for a relatively low price. The problem comes, of course, is when you finish the film, is getting it seen. You know, getting theatrical releases now is virtually impossible. There's lots of other outlets, but that is still the stumbling block. Because, to be honest, there's too many films out there, in a way. Having said it's easier to make them, the downside on that is there's just so many films out there. It's very crowded. So it's very competitive.